Hello, this is the fifth devlog for Archvale. We've got a menu screen now, so that's good. It's been quite a while since I've done one of these, probably 3 months now. The game has been in full progress the whole time, I've been making it the whole time. The only reason I haven't made devlogs is just because I've been ridiculously busy besides the game. But hopefully I'll be making these more often now. So one of the first things I've set up in the game now is sub-biomes inside of biomes. So obviously we have biomes such as the desert and the forest, but inside of those biomes now there are sub-biomes. So in the forest there's a base forest biome, but there's also offshoots such as a very flowery area with bees nests, and that's the only place you'll find bees nests, and those can have varying frequencies. There can be as many of those sub biomes as I want. There's some more interesting ones in the underground, so I can actually provide different room templates and completely different enemy sets in these sub biomes. So one of the sub biomes is a kind of spider denny place with spiders rushing at you and webs everywhere. The other is a kind of underground abandoned mine full of undead miner people, and this is something that I want to make sure is prominent in the game, because it makes exploring what is pretty much the same biome more interesting. Even though you'll be doing things inside the biome that should make it interesting already, it's just a bit more fun to come across varied environments and varied enemies as you go. So magic has received quite an overhaul in the past 3 or so months. When I say overhaul, it's basically got the basic functionality of any magic in any game. You know, a mana bar, and you use the mana when you shoot. There's tomes as well as staffs now, and the tomes kind of are a bit looser. You can't aim them as well, but they kind of home in on your enemies. There's also equipment that can add to the damage you deal with certain weapon types. So there's ranger apparel, which can increase your range damage, and magic apparel, which can increase your magic damage and increases your mana, and it can increase whatever stats I want, and I can add more stats to do more things, and that's something that will obviously be explored much more further down the line. I'm planning on quite a lot more equipment than is currently in the game in the future. We've been working on adding new locations. So there's a template, a skeleton for a swamp biome. We're basically going to add a bunch of these skeleton locations and then start to fill them in with content later down the line. But for now, we're just going to get skeletons ready. So we have two bosses now. There's a big slime boss and a big worm boss. So I'll show those now. The slime boss is quite easy right now, I think. Like, it's not particularly difficult, especially if you've got any starter gear. The boss damage and difficulty is going to need some significant rebalancing once we know exactly how each biome's how much your power level is going to increase over the course of a biome. So this is something that's going to take a while for me to work out. And it's really difficult to do, because it requires just lots of sitting down and thinking, and it requires me to know everything about the game, which is a part of the reason why we are setting up all the skeleton biomes, because, you know, we get a broad idea of everything in the game and we can start to scale things correctly. The worm boss right now is kind of broken. I accidentally left in a very low health version of the boss. I had to use the wooden sword to not just basically kill it instantly, and I used the iron bow to kind of skip on phases once I got bored of them. I'm not overly happy with the design of it right now, but it's not my priority until, you know, we're actually designing the content in order. So a lot of people have been asking about a Discord server, and I think that's probably a good idea to set up soon. So be on the lookout for that. I'll probably make a video and tweet, so you should probably follow my Twitter if you care about that. So that's it for this video. I'm going to be trying to make these more regularly from here on out, because I know that was a long break, and I should not have taken that long a break from these videos. So hopefully I will see you much sooner this time. Thank you for watching, and thank you for all the support. It's been a lot of support on the YouTube videos, so thanks guys, and see you next time.